Hello there, everybody. DJ Numa here with Dawn of Roxas.
Hi.
And welcome to the Season 7 Budokai Bowl for the Dragon Ball Z Leagues, Minor Leagues. This is like our Super Bowl. This is the final match combined with the MVP tournament and the Gauntlet. So, are you ready, Dawn?
Never. Let's do it.
Alright, round one, let's begin. We've got the lefties going up against the baldies in the final of this year. Lefties hoping to get their Budokai championship that they sorely missed out on after a great fight last year.
I don't think they can do it.
I mean, they haven't changed builds at all, so.
Yeah. Oh, at least they got a chance. That's so confident there.
Oh, yeah.
Confidence wins wars.
Of course. And Nail already off to a smashing start.
Confidence wins wars.
Oh, man. And
confidence
wins. Aww, Dodori Headbreaker.
Confidence dodges attacks.
Obviously. Nail's just mad about last year.
You know what dodging attacks leads to?
What?
Winning wars.
Oh my god, I didn't know, dude.
Yeah, look.
Hit, Nail stalling. You know what that leads to, right?
Confidence.
Full power energy waves.
And confidence.
Much more confidence.
And confidence leads to confidence.
And Dodori has run out of confidence. And in comes Piccolo.
Maybe Piccolo has more confidence to kick Piccolo's ass.
Yeah, right? Of course, this is Kamikolo, so, you know, he's got all of the confidence.
Yeah, well, Nail here's like a third of Kamikolo, so he's got this.
I mean, obviously, look at that. Holy crap. He's doing the same thing he did last season.
Confidence wins wars.
The theme of tonight's episode, confidence wins wars.
And full power energy waves lead to confidence.
You know what confidence does, right?
Yeah.
It leads to Nail actually losing 2 health bars.
See, Piccolo has more confidence than Vidoria.
Obviously.
Nail still has the most confidence on this battlefield so far.
I mean, if Piccolo hadn't missed with his first light grenade and actually had a chance to do something, maybe he'd be better off. But as it stands right now, he's losing confidence at an alarming rate.
That's not life totals, that's confidence bars.
Yup. That means that the Super Saiyans have a ton of it. Oh, man.
Every strike makes you lose a little bit of confidence.
Just a little bit.
Which is actually true, if you think about it.
Yep, because every hit to the face just makes you a little bit more. That's not going to hit Piccolo. Oh. And he's out.
And every time you watch a player get hit, it's like, oh, is he going to go down to this person?
Yeah. Oh, Krillin, wrong idea. Wrong idea, little guy.
And it's the confidence of the people.
Yeah. And the Baldies, who are 9-2 going into the playoffs, they're dropping the ball in this first round. I've got to be honest.
Well, to Nail. They're losing out to superior confidence.
They're losing out to Nail, specifically.
And his superior confidence.
Yeah.
He's more confident than the entire enemy team.
My god.
Oh, never mind. Krillin's got this.
Krillin's definitely got this.
I'm getting mixed signals here, Krillin.
Krillin? Don't worry, guys. I got this. You're getting kicked in the face. I got it!
Do something, Krillin. There's a boot in my ass!
Oh, God!
There's a Limakian boot in my eye!
Nail is elite. Off of... just...
That was a
Nail,
weird camera
Nail
angle.
Just went elite. And he's lost Krillin.
Ow!
He's found Krillin. Krillin, launch a Destructo Disc. Alright, now launch a Destructo Disc. Hey, Krillin's got this!
At the end.
That's a try beam.
This is in this entire league, so, in this entire season.
Yep.
Can the man with the confidence. In fact, I feel like Nail was getting confidence from Tien.
Oh, of course. Of course. No, I mean, never mind the fact that future Gohan's on the team. But, you know.
Yeah, I mean, really. We're talking about confidence. Tien's the man to look to.
Oh, yeah, look what he did to the Gohan. Stop doing that, Krillin! You're not hitting anyone! Krillin has the most confidence. And never mind.
He could still take out Tien.
He could, if he tags.
Tien just derps from now on, okay.
Okay, never mind. Bye, Krillin!
Then comes the Doria.
Hello, Dodoria. Oh, Dodoria's got Dendes. Forgot about that. That exists. Chemical!
Confidence laser.
Confidence beam.
Now that Nail's out of the picture, Dodoria comes out with renewed confidence.
Yes.
Ow.
This is actually turning into a fairly alright fight. I mean,
confidence sense.
Yeah.
Pump confidence.
Dodoria is pumping up all of it. Is he going to do it more than once?
Confidence try beam.
Three of them. Holy cow. Tien used his ultimate 3 times. That's a new record for him, isn't it?
He did that like 2 weeks ago.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I forgot. Tien doesn't show the amount of confidence that Nail does. I mean, Nail just ate that Kamehameha last year.
Yeah. He was
and
confident.
Kept going.
You know, it looked like Dodoria fit perfectly inside of that tri-beam.
And it just didn't go anywhere near him.
It went around him.
Oh yeah.
This is why your attacks shouldn't look like geometry.
Failed geometry at that. He's putting a square through a triangle hole. This doesn't work like this. Piccolo!
He was putting a square through a circle.
Piccolo, you almost had enough to do Hellzone Grenade. Why? And this was a slaughter. Gohan hasn't even hit the field. All because of Nail's confidence.
I feel like...
What?
Okay. Okay, she's leaving.
Oh, the kitty?
Yeah.
Oh, are we gonna see it? I think we might see it. False courage!
Confidence blast!
And Gohan didn't even need to hit the field. Ouch.
I feel like Gohan is the most confident person here because he didn't need to get he didn't try to get tagged in.
That's true. That is definitely true. Anyway, next up, we've got the MVP tournament. Here's the bracket for you guys. First up, we're going to have Kid Goku go up against Early Goku. And then that is followed by Mercenary Tao taking on King Cold. Hello, Zalibrator. And then Turles versus PyCon and Supreme Kai versus Nappa. And then we move on to round 2 with it. Yeah. So, shall we begin, Don?
Yeah, cool.
All right.
Seems good.
So, you guys will notice the format's a little different for these. It's because I've done my best to get which teams have actually posted builds for the MVP tournament and put their characters in.
Okay. Good.
That's custom dialogue. How come you're wearing an outfit that looks like
the
mine?
The bracket is still very much in my face.
Oh, the bracket's... Oh, God. Oh, God. There we go.
It's still in my face. There. Okay.
And the chat's just yelling at me. And the chat's yelling at me. Nice if we could see. And it's actually a pretty good fight between these two.
I'm like, wow, the screen share got really good all of a sudden. That's because I was staring at the stream.
Oh, Kamehameha hits from Goku.
This is awkward.
Isn't it? I wonder if anybody...
Goku really taking it to Goku.
I know, right? You should have heard their dialogue at the beginning of the match. Why is he wearing an outfit that looks like mine? Hey, you look just like me when I was little.
Huh. This is early Goku. Oh, yeah, it is, because he doesn't have any shoes.
Yep.
That's how you can tell it's early Goku, due to lack of shoes.
Oh, yeah. That's Kaioken. And I'm pretty sure this will actually bring out Kid Goku.
No, I don't think so.
Yeah. Oh!
Goku, I had confidence in you, but Goku just took you to town, Goku. God damn.
Alright. So.
Goku, why?
So, early Goku moves on, and I can't figure out how to edit the brackets. This is a problem.
We'll figure it out later.
Yep, we'll figure it out later. Anyway, let's go back and set up for round two. So it will be early Goku versus late Piccolo. Ah, dang it. It was almost a canon match. Next up, we've got Mercenary Tao, who's got that build.
Yes.
Versus King Cold, who has this build.
What is that?
Let's watch, shall we?
No, I think we could look away.
Oh.
I don't see anything! Woo!
What?
I've turned away. Can't watch.
Oh! Tao's here! Versing King Cold.
Yeah, go King Cold!
The original Dodonpa!
Yeah, go Tao!
Why are you Oh, wait! These are both your teams!
I have no opinion. I actually don't care for either of these characters, so really I have no opinion.
Really?
Yeah.
But you built Tao to be the freaking Dodonpa inducing wizard that he is.
Did I?
Yeah! You gave him that build.
Huh.
See? Come on, right.
No, honestly, I've been paying too much attention to King Veggie and Android 19.
You mean General Blue?
No. No. just no.
No. What? You got something against General Blue?
Everything. Why? What do you?
You know, gotta be honest here.
Thank God King Cole's throw slams him to the right instead of down.
You oh, know, yeah, right?
Like a double-fisted strike you think would.
Yeah.
That words came out of my mouth.
Yeah, right? Like, these two fighting actually this is a pretty good fight. Very conscientious of where the fans are, though. Oh! Pencil? No pencil? And
no, I will step on his groin!
Yes!
I'm General Ow!
I'm Mercenary Ow! God, why?
I'm General, get the hell out of my face!
Oh, he almost ringed out King Cold there.
Damn right, we're playing Smash Brothers! Don't, Andre! Man, it would really suck if you couldn't fly!
Right?
Wait, can I fly? I don't remember!
Who are you people?
I think I just won this because he's about to go into the.
Hey! And a ring out from Tao!
Look at my pencil.
Look at my pencil. It's amazing. Oh, man. And dirt next up... Dirt on pencil. Next up, we've got PyCon. Who will have Rising Fighting Spirit? Versus Turles.
Versus Turtles.
Versus Turtles. That's not the right build. That's not the right build. That's not the right... That is the right build.
Alright, just tell me the match starts.
Match is starting.
Well, if you figure this out. You seem very confused.
So many builds for this week. And the chat just exploded for Tao.
If by exploded, you mean one person was celebrating.
Yep. Completely.
Explosions!
Building kick. Explosions!
Fruit versus...
Oh, man. PyCon starts off by a burning sheet that gets blocked.
It's Fruit versus Penis Hat. Who will win?
You know what I really want to see? I want to see PyCon just ring himself out.
After screaming at Turles for an hour?
Yes. Insulting Turles for an hour would be better.
Just punch each other in the face for an hour, insulting each other.
Oh man. I mean, nothing will beat when King Cole just ran away from Frieza, though.
No, son! Don't!
Frieza was like, I will kill you. And Piccolo was like, nope, 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 nope. Oh, Cheerios! And PyCon is having his
Did
ass
you mean
thoroughly...
King Cold, by the way?
No.
Because you said King Cold.
I meant King Piccolo.
Okay. No, son, don't! Punch me!
Presenting me! Oh! Fruit!
So we have Haruman in the call to call you on your shit.
Thankfully. That's a Thunder Flash. And all of a sudden, it's almost even again.
Because I literally have paid no attention to the main league in, like, years.
And... Oh! Who just won that? PyCon won on a ring out.
I'm confused. PyCon! PyCon, like PyCon rang himself out. How'd he win?
I don't know! I saw him ring himself out, too! What?!
The referees on the field have deemed that he won, though.
Oh, okay. I think that the referees are wrong, personally. So PyCon will be going on to fight Zarbon. Damn. And we move on to the next match. While we all sit there in confusion, where we've got Supreme Kai... That's the gauntlet build. Right? Crap. Hold on. There's so many builds that they're so similar, I need to check to see if this is the gauntlet build or not. What Kai is he in? He's in North Kai. Alright. Okay, so, custom 2. Versus who, exactly?
The people.
Nappa.
It's the people versus Nappa.
With his 4-point build. Or is it... Yep, with his 4-point build. And he's going full-on Saiyan Warrior in this one. I mean, I'm going to be honest with the coach here for 2.5 Saiyans Yubel. That was just bad luck, because it looked like PyCon ran into the wall before Turles hit the ground. I don't know. Anyway, right now we've got Nappa versus Supreme Kai. This was a good match in the main league run. Let's see if it's just as good as a match here.
Yes.
Yes, quite. Alright. So, why are they just punching each other in the face? I mean, I understand why Nappa is, but why is Supreme Kai just punching him in the face?
Because punch.
He's got squares to hit people with in the face, and energy's lost!
And that's Tien who has squares.
No, Tien has triangles.
More fisticuffs.
More fisticuffs.
Really, these two men have decided that they are going to fly as high as possible and then hurt each other until one of them falls down.
I mean, I can agree with the... And Supreme Kai wins.
What the fuck just happened?
I think Nappa just got run into the ringside. So now we've got late Piccolo versus early Goku. But we will wait until the next match for that one. Or until after we have our first round of the Gauntlet for that. So, Dawn. Dawn, I'm going to have to say, I'll see you in a little bit.
What just happened?
I don't know! Anyway, it's time for the Gauntlet, which we have a special guest commentator for.
Hello.
Hello, Harabe.
I would just like to say it's really hard to work on this take-home exam when I'm, like, watching the pretty much replay on the stream for what you're laughing at. Yeah, that looked kind of painful for Nappa to land this, like, chest stomach first onto, like, the rail thing.
Yeah. Yeah. Anyway... We're on the Gauntlet now, round one specifically. Can any team make it past this beefed-up Gauntlet? For those of you who don't know, we actually had to wait a week because I had to revamp the Gauntlet and make it harder because I put a test team up against it and they obliterated. So
I would just like to say I'm cheering for the beefed-up people.
Well, I know why you are.
Well, yeah, but I also don't know much about minor leagues to have much faith in them.
Yeah, fair enough.
Sorry.
Anyway, first up, we've got North Kai going up against the people who are feared. The team Fear from the main league. We've got Nom, Frieza, and Kid Buu.
Yeah, that is a scary team.
Right? Cross arm attack from Nom to start things off. Ooh.
And it hits. Gotta love these screen shares.
Oh yeah.
Makes it very easy to co-commentate on this.
Oh yeah, sure.
Also, why is
Clash? Tyga's gonna win. Very nicely done from Goku.
Yeah.
Wait, this is a canon match!
Oh my god!
Canon match!
Except I don't think Nam was wearing yellow and blue.
Silence, mortal. Tis just Nam. And Goku's at max power. Nam's at max power. These are not fair builds at all, by the way.
It didn't look like Nam was at max power at all when you said that.
Nam, I believe, is currently running Eternal Life, Attack Up 3. Yeah, the build I put on Nam isn't legal whatsoever. But Goku's doing very well against him.
Oh yeah, despite being about a bar below him.
Yeah. I mean, it's going to be hard to beat him simply because of the health regeneration.
Oh, yeah.
But still.
Either way, Kid Goku here is keeping up, and I'm just not going to finish that same sentence.
You've just discovered the curse of the commentator. Goku is out.
Goku
in comes Kai.
And in comes Supreme Kai.
Yep.
We're going to see the fleshy, ticky things.
Of course. But the question is, will we see energies last? That's what all his ultimate is, too. He fires the same move and just calls it a different thing.
Yes.
One has a bigger beam radius. I'm sorry. That's it.
It's because he's putting the last of his energy into it.
Oh, yeah.
Which we all know isn't right. And Zemo DBC is wondering if you've just... Yeah, never mind.
Yeah, they were... I had them originally, and again, too easy. I decided that it would probably be a better idea to just beef them up a bit. You'll see why.
And it looks like Supreme Kai is somewhat taking it to Nam. But...
Yeah.
Ow, that combination that Nam just had.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Like, I'd like to point this out. Nam's taken down most of the bars on Goku, and half of Supreme Kai.
Yes.
And he hasn't hit his last health bar yet.
I would just like to say, I want to see Frieza in this fight.
Hey, look! Energy's last! And in comes Frieza.
Yay! My wish came true. Bye, Nam. Hi, Frieza.
Hello, Frieza with Super Up 3. I want you to use your ultimate, please.
Come on, please. Destroy the Earth. Destroy
He's
the
literally
planet.
On last year's... Hey!
Yay! Oh! This hit! It's clashing! Please tell me you put, like, a really good clash. Yeah!
Oh, my dear. And he's back at max.
Oh, my God. 24,000.
And in comes Subito Kai!
Hello. Oh, my God.
I may or may not have made Frieza a bit too powerful. Oops.
It's Team Powerful, or pure Team Feared, or whatever. What do you expect? Also,
this is the most
planned...
He's
gonna need a tag if this... I don't think he's gonna get the chance. Nope.
No. And in comes Gohan.
It's Gohan. Gonna be really hard for this team to pick up the slack.
Frieza might die this time.
Oh.
Don't charge it, don't charge it. Aw, oh, crap.
Aww.
I'm really rooting for North Kai here, because... I think they have one of the better chances of beating them. They had the most planning out of all of the Kais. Actually, West Kai had a lot of planning done. But this Kai had the most planning and probably the best, the
chances.
Most powerful characters to run through. Minus Goku.
Hello, Lone Fox. But yeah...
And another one.
Then again, sometimes a whole lot of planning doesn't really pay off. Also, I love how we're on this map and no B2s have been eaten yet, from what I have seen.
Yeah, I would love to see Goku just take down Frieza. Please.
Oh, no, not in kid form.
Yeah, in kid form.
Kid Goku has no chance. Look at that health difference.
So I will again go over... With the next match, I'll go over
the builds for these people.
The builds for
Team Feared.
Team Fear. That's what I'm calling them. Because you are to fear this team.
As we can clearly see, maybe this should have been the last round.
No, I'm thinking it might have been the second, except for the fact that the second round is more powerful.
Mind you, people, I don't know who exactly is in the gauntlet, so...
You have an idea.
I do have an idea of, like, one person.
Yeah. Anyways, that was... You took down half of Frieza.
And you took down Nam.
Yeah. So it's north, east, west, south, I believe?
Yes.
Okay, so first up, we've got Nappa.
Is he gonna catch a Pokemon?
Oh, yeah. He's gonna catch a Frieza. And
good
then we've got early Goku.
Good luck with that. It's like catching an Arceus or whatever they're called. Nappa's trying to catch a god.
I forgot to change something. Hold on, folks. I forgot to change Goku to Super Up 2.
Yep. So, chat, how are all of you doing?
Alright, we're good.
Never mind! It doesn't seem to be important anymore.
Oh, man. I might boost up the other guys, or I might take off the Dendes next season. Or not the Dendes, the Roshi's training next season. Because I did boost the Bills themselves as well.
Hello, Mr. FCD. Yes, tonight is the night.
Tonight is the night.
The party.
And then Garlic sweep the leg, Junior. With that filled. Can they take on? Oh, damn it. You're supposed to be Nappa in here. I mean, I'm really disappointed in just how the teams did, planning-wise. Because, as you can see, this required a lot more planning.
Mm-hmm. I mean, just look at North Kai. They did a lot of planning, but...
Sad to say, it didn't exactly work.
All that planning, dropped the gun, wasn't enough.
Dropped the ball?
Eh, either one works.
Anyway, Nom's build.
I mean, none of them used guns. I mean, seriously.
So there's Nom's build. It has attack of 3, light body, eternal life, indomitable fighting spirit, quick fast attack, Roshi's training, and rising fighting spirit with Cell AI.
Now here's the question, why didn't you put power body on him instead of light body?
I literally based all of these builds off of their main roster builds.
Fair enough.
Frieza, super of 3, light body, savior, Kabuto, secret art, launches support, Emperor's aura, and Master Roshi's training with TN AI.
Again, I don't know what Master Roshi's training does. I've asked you like three times.
It adds in another health bar and 2 blast stock limit.
Oh, nice. And I don't know if Emperor's Aura is on here.
Well, you see, okay, Zilo, you didn't post the actual builds, so I came up with...
Replacement
for it. Kid Buu is the last one. He's got Key Up 3, Savior, Indignation, Combo Master, Dragon Power, Launch Support, and Roshi's Training with TNAI.
This is why it's important to post builds, people. I mean, just look at the blades, too. I believe it was the blades.
Anyways, can East Kai do it?
Let's find out. Wait, why the fuck Emperor's Aura? No, he doesn't need the plus two to supers.
Oh, yes, he does.
I don't think Emperor's Aura did that.
Yup.
One moment.
Yup. Yup. As I said.
No, Emperor's Aura just increased the power to stun opponents.
No.
And it lasts.
Emperor's Aura is style of the strong for evil.
I'm reading it right now. Plus effect, max power mode lasts 50% longer, increased power to stun opponent.
And we've got Numb versus Nappa.
It doesn't say that it...
That's cross arm attack.
Supers.
This...
Nappa just loves to be shirtless, doesn't he?
Oh, yeah. I mean, look at that. If you had that physique, would you like to be shirtless, too? Of course you would. You just gotta show it off.
I mean, I'm a girl, so I'm not sure if I could ever have that physique.
Nonsense.
I would have
use enough steroids
something.
And you'd be fine.
I'd have at least something on, because I don't want to be flaunting these as much as I'm proud of them. I'm not clarifying that. Apparently, Zilo did post their character.
you posted your character, yes, and I'm going off of other characters that were posted in there. But still, oh, and Nam has the most confidence right now.
Nam has all of the confidence. Come on, Nappa. It's just a human.
Do something!
Nappa, it's just a human. You eat those for breakfast. Awkward silence ensues because of that comment. Yay!
No, I was just eating my dinner.
Oh, great. I'm here without food in my dorm. Oh, I do have cereal, but I mean,
Nam is just eating Nappa.
Yeah. I mean, there's water within Nappa.
Nappa has literally done nothing.
Good job.
Literally nothing.
Bye, Nappa. Taggy useless.
Literally nothing. That's an ultimate.
I mean, this is somewhat of a canon match. It's like a revenge match.
Bye, Goku.
Be glad he didn't have Super Plus 3.
And, yeah, definitely taking Roshi's training off next year. Yeah, this is
brutal.
This is brutal. But you know what? That's what it's supposed to be. I asked, do you want to have a weaker gauntlet or no gauntlet this week or no gauntlet at all? No. I said I needed to make it stronger so we could either run no gauntlet or wait a week. They chose to wait a week.
Well.
GG,
you
guys.
You made the option, guys. You have to pay the consequences.
Yeah.
For the villagers!
It'd be amusing to see if South Kai did it. Because I think South Kai had the least amount. No, West Kai. No, South Kai had the least. Never mind, no.
One of them had less than the other.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think we're going to be seeing Frieza this time.
Mm-mm.
Man, this is just brutal. Mom's only down half a health bar. Scratch that. A health bar.
Two health bars. Goku at the end here is actually doing something. He's taking Nam down to half health. But I don't think Garlic Jr. is going to have any chance to do much. Because he's coming in. He doesn't have Savior. He's on his sweep the leg build. And it doesn't look like Nam's giving anyone a chance to do anything. Like, at all this match. So again, this is just more fuel for next season. Guys, yeah. you gotta do more planning. At least now you know what the first builds are.
Well, minus Roshi's training.
Minus Roshi's training. We won't give them Roshi's training. Good try at sleeping the leg though, Garlic.
For the villagers.
So, yeah.
Did not
so
go
far,
off.
Yeah. So far, North Kai defeated Nam, I think, right? No, Nam defeated North Kai. He tagged at the last moment. Mm-hmm. Or did Frieza? But it was
Frieza,
Nam and Frieza.
Frieza defeated the rest of North Kai.
Yeah. So far, North Kai making it the furthest.
Mm-hmm.
Garlic doing that thing that got TNAI banned on him.
Yes.
That being spammy.
Will he take down Nam?
I don't
know. And show us Frieza?
I don't know.
It looks very likely.
Yeah, right? I'm just surprised that Videl wasn't in. Videl is Miss Spamalot.
Honestly, at this rate, I think East Kai might be ahead, depending on if they take out Nam or not, because Nam tagged. Never mind. It's a tie. Hi, Frieza. Shame you can't do stuff like this in the main league.
Well, there's none of this is fair. This is like a 14-point build.
Exactly.
Hey, Frieza's down a health bar.
Sealed Blabag.
Destroy the planet, that's over!
Oh my god! Bye, garlic.
That only did 13,000 points of damage, though. But it's yeah, that it was over as soon as Frieza came out.
Yeah, and I'm sort of feeling bad.
But,
you know, I mean, they did give me leeway to go on and just smack the crap out of them.
Sure. Now, can you please explain to me how Emperor's Aura gives Supers another +2? Because in the description for the main league customization things, it doesn't say that at all.
It literally is Style of the Strong.
It doesn't it's say literally that. It just increases stun.
It's literally Style of the Strong for evil characters. I'll show you. Alright. And then we've got Nom.
It says it increases the stun, though. Not the ultimates.
Alright. Eh. Oh well.
Because I was going to ask you, why didn't you put Style of the Strong on Frieza? That would, like, give him, like, 30,000 points of damage for an ultimate. Oh, now I'm conflicted. I just noticed who's fighting.
Yeah, who do you want to go with? Daddy or Sunny Boy?
You mean Daddy's Little Princess?
Mm-hmm.
Well, considering Daddy's Little Princess isn't fighting Daddy, we'll see. For now, I want King Cole to just wreck Nom shit.
Yeah.
I doubt it.
Again.
But
this is also the first time that the Gauntlet has ever been run in the minor leagues. Mm-hmm. So, again, little balancing needed, obviously. In tests, it wasn't this bad, but in tests, I was also doing, like, builds made to counter them. So, thinking about it, this is probably a horrible idea.
Well, if you don't experiment, you never learn.
Yeah. So, I mean, these builds, I did add some stuff into after last week, just because I was annihilating them with stuff like Super Boo. Like, I'm pretty sure I put them up against the lefties and then the Evolution of Evil, and they were just getting annihilated. So yeah, I'm now arguing with chat, because, Zilo helped me test the original builds, and said it was difficult. Well, it was difficult, but it wasn't hard. It was too easy to surmount, in my opinion. This is too hard. Again, you have to practice with these things to know. But next year, I'll tone it down a little bit.
Not only that, but I think last season, the main league, the first round wrecked everyone but one team, I believe.
Who, I believe, went on to win it?
Yeah. It was either one or two teams that passed the first round,
but
either way,
yeah,
it was a slaughter for the other two teams, at the very least.
Yeah.
So, it's supposed to be really hard to win unless you do extensive planning and figuring it out, because in the main league we knew that the first one was going to be heavy attack, and the second round was going to be heavy defense, and then the third round was a mystery because we never got to the third round before.
Yeah.
We knew how to try and counter it, but either way, even with that knowledge, we lost pretty heavily.
Yeah, honestly, West Sky here, who didn't do any planning whatsoever, and I'm pretty
it's
sure
so
King
far
Cold.
In the lead.
King Cold is the only one who had a build posted.
Not only that, but he seems to be, he seemed to do the most to Nom thus far, taking him down to 2 health bars left. Let's see if the fabulous Zarbon can keep up on it or just run away.
Yeah. Anyway, Zarbon jumps the gun and comes in before PyCon. I don't know if that was such a good idea, because Zarbon is not that good at countering melee. Mm-hmm. PyCon can keep up. Zarbon can't. The Eternal Life may also have been a bit much.
A little bit. Then Dice probably would have been fine.
Yeah. But again, these are based off of builds they have in the main league. So you can look back to Season 6, end of Season 6, and that's basically the builds I used. Eternal Life was on Nom at the end of Season 6, so I used that build. And I just added a couple of things to it. And Master versus Training. But Zarbon, taking out half of Nom, or most of Nom now.
Shooting Star Arrow, misses.
Yeah. If Zarbon ultimates, he can take out Nom right mm-hmm. now. And
then they'll
if he tags, PyCon comes in versus Frieza and can annihilate Frieza.
Mm-hmm.
But as it stands right now, Zarbon needs to get in there, take out Nom, annihilate Frieza.
Or tag.
How did that hit?
Bounced, I think.
And a pile driver. And Zarbon transforms.
Oh, really? Oh, he's not fabulous anymore. God.
He's also not on the field anymore.
Yeah, that too. So at least I don't have to look at him that long. It's all up to PyCon.
It's all up to PyCon. Down goes Nom.
Wait, Nom is dead?
Mm-hmm.
This guy is now in the lead. Good job!
Yep. And PyCon, doing work.
PyCon, yes.
Get away from there, PyCon. Oh yeah, I'm definitely toning this all down next year.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, please hit. Please hit. Please hit. Please hit. It hit! Barely.
Oh. Just skimmed
it. I think Frieza blocked it.
He might have, yeah.
No way. No way.
Oh.
No!
PyCon, oh.
Damn it, PyCon.
Mind you, I took Japanese last year, so I am...
You're just gonna say PyCon.
The Japanese. Yeah, because yeah. That's technically the Japanese pronunciation is PyCon.
Yeah, but, poor PyCon.
Yeah.
PyCon was their best chance of defeating Frieza, and I just don't think that he can do it now.
Well, this is the lowest Frieza's been, if I can recall, so...
Yeah. So, again, they're doing really, really well.
Mm-hmm.
Oof. And down goes PyCon. After taking Frieza down the longest, the most that any of the characters have.
Mm-hmm. So far, this West Kai is one.
Yeah, so far the West Kai has made it the furthest. Alright, and now, next up we have who? South Kai. The Southern Bells. We start out with Android 19. Very good at countering Nom.
Such a Southern Bell he is.
Yep. Then we've got End Goku.
Oh, he's just a beaut.
Oh, yeah. And he could go to Super Saiyan 3. We don't know. Wait. Yeah, that's the build. Costume 3. And then we've got Krillin.
Oh my god, he's such a cutie.
Yep. From the Baldies. In Costume 2. Versus Nom. Frieza. And Kid Buu. Kid Buu's build is probably the least broken out of all of them.
Shame he hasn't come out yet.
Yeah, right. Anyway,
now let's see
I
if
really
these
hope.
Ladies can be Team Feared.
I really, really hope that they can beat Team Fear.
Here's to hoping.
Think.
Considering that after this, I'm no longer needed.
Well, after the gauntlet, that is.
Yeah. I mean, if they lose.
This is going to be indicative on how bad it is.
And how much energy 19 takes. I almost said Nom.
It'd
be amusing if Nom could take energy like he needs to take bits of water. Like,
if 19 can grab Nom over and over again.
It's doable.
Oh, he went for the grab and got B2'd instead.
So close.
So close.
I don't know which costume I like better on 19. His original costume or this one?
I like the blue. Honestly.
Yeah, but it's less, eye-hurting, I want to say. I don't know the right word.
Yeah. It really depends on if Kid Buu comes out. Because if Kid Buu comes out, it's just going to be insane. Oh, there's a grab!
Oh.
Well done, 19. High power rush, connects!
That energy he stole from Numb. Very smart, 19.
Now grab him again. Grab him again. Aw.
Nah, he doesn't have enough energy.
He has enough energy.
Jeez, look at that T rate. That is impressive.
And 19, just being turned around.
You never want your back to an opponent. Very bad idea. Oh, after image. Oh, Nom. 19's got it. Never mind.
19's just done. And in comes Krillin, jumping the gun. He's got Savior. He could take out Nom.
Yeah. All health bars of him. Totally possible.
Krillin, why did you waste that? Oh my god.
The cliff finally ate a B2! Yay! Cliff, I'm so proud. He got his food.
Nom.
Hey, Cliff's gotta eat too. It's got
Cliff's
a family
gotta
to
eat.
Look after.
Cliff's gotta eat. Again, I think without the extra health bar and without eternal life on Nom, this would have been doable. So I sincerely apologize to everybody who was really, really excited about this. I may have made it a bit too hard.
Next season, with this knowledge, will be a bit easier.
Yeah. I may also run another one in a couple weeks. Same teams, just maybe a little easier.
As a sort of sorry for accidentally making this too OP.
Yes.
Now the question is, will the title of Gauntlet winner also be given there? If there is a winner.
Well, it'll just be the first rounds again.
Fair enough. Because you want to keep the second and third round a secret.
Yes.
I'm curious on where the person you were telling me about...
Second round.
Okay. Thank you.
Yep.
Wondering if they were in third round or... whatnot.
And in comes Goku, and they're not even on Frieza yet.
Yeah, so far this seems to be...
I think
Max
Power...
I
think
so.
Final Form Frieza... Okay, Goku's got Max Power, and Frieza's coming in. He could still do this.
Then again, Frieza's gonna have Max Power too, so if they both ult at the same time... Oh, Super Spirit Bomb! Here we go!
Now, will it do extra damage based on the fact that Frieza is so dang evil?
Let's find out.
It does 14,000. And Frieza might die this time. Goku dodged it! Goku knows how to dodge! Yeah!
Goku might sweep.
Third round is definitely hell. Frieza's looking a little worse for wear. I hope he goes max power and just produces that key charge. Now, if Goku beats Frieza in Super Saiyan 1 form, is that a canon fight?
Yes.
No.
Thanks, Dawn.
I mean, it's Super Saiyan 1. Super Saiyan 1 versus Frieza's canon.
That's a Kamehameha to the face. And so far, Goku has made this the closest one yet.
Goku might take this Kai to the second round.
And Frieza just got... had Goku eat the cliff.
Mm-hmm.
Or Frieza's might die this time, just ate the cliff. Goku's dodging. In comes Kid Boo!
Kid Boo! Good job, Cell Kai. Oh. Goku, good job having your back to your opponent.
And a planet burst.
Oh, look at
that. And a planet burst!
Yeah. Yeah.
And wait till you see Kid Boo's charge rate.
Okay, wow. Alright. Alright, that's a bit much.
Key up 3! What? Super Saiyan 2!
Oh.
Full power!
Woo!
This is a canon match!
Alright!
Oh!
Oh!
Oh! Kid Buu wins it!
Screecher!
And down goes Goku!
Do this to me? Oh, that was. Gonna have to say, this
very
was probably
close.
The closest because Kid Buu actually came on the field.
That was excellent.
A good showing by Goku.
So as you see, guys, it's not impossible.
You just have to have Goku go Super Saiyan.
You have to have Goku go Super Saiyan, and Kid Buu had to, you know, not have Dragon Power, and that may have gone better.
A little bit.
That was an excellent, excellent ending to the first Gauntlet. Again, I'm sorry that it was so overpowered, but again, it's all a learning experience.
Rematches will be had later at a later time with easier.
And we will see just how good the builds were. So.
Bye now.
And bye, Harume. Thank you for coming.
I'm just
and
gonna
also,
mute
Kid
myself
Buu,
in case
Kid
you
Buu
need
always
me anymore.
Does have Dragon Power. So.
Bye.
Bye. So we are on to round 2 of the Gauntlet. Or not the Gauntlet, the MVP tournament, which features Goku.
Speaking of Goku, it's not a canon fight because it's the wrong Goku.
What, Nappa versus early Goku?
No, mid Goku's the one who fought Frieza.
Details.
Not the right Goku.
My new details, get over them.
Like 3 of them. Not that hard.
Okay, and this is costume 4 versus late Piccolo. And I believe this is the late Piccolo, and it's outfit 2. So yeah.
Just like how this would be a canon fight if it was early Piccolo.
Yep. That was a canon fight with Kid Buu, though.
Yeah.
And that was an excellent ending to the Gauntlet. I mean, we have to admit that. It was an excellent ending.
If Goku was on Player 2, he would have gotten vaporized.
Yeah? Yeah? Yes, Zilo, you get to go against late Piccolo. And honestly, this is going rather well so far for early Goku. Much better than the Gauntlet match did.
I don't know, I was making boiled eggs when Android 19 was out, so I didn't get to see that part.
Oh, they're getting into the danger zone here. Oh...
it's not gonna ring out.
Kaioken from a Goku.
From one of the 3 Gokus.
They can clash with Light Grenade? Piccolo wins it!
All of a sudden it's an even fight again.
Yeah.
Also, Goku and looking like Goku. A hoodlum now.
Yeah, not looking too good there, Goku.
half his shirt's missing.
It is. Wait, I was right in putting early Goku in here, right? It wasn't Kid Goku that won? Chat's not yelling at me, so you know what? Oh! Oh. Ring out from Piccolo!
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Wait, ring out. Ring
he
out
knocked
Piccolo
him into the building. And Piccolo wow. moves on to the semifinals.
That match had a dearth of commentating. That was great.
A dearth?
Lack of.
Hmm.
I pulled out the big words.
Okay. Hey, who won? Tao or King Cold?
Tao.
Okay. Are yeah. you just saying that?
No, Tao won.
Okay. So now we have Garlic Jr. up against Tao.
If you don't believe me, check the tapes!
The tapes!
Tapes.
Tapes. Versus Tao. I feel really, really bad about that gauntlet. Is this your build, Dawn, for the...
I don't know.
Anywho.
I don't know.
I don't know.
I spent three weeks thanks to the playoffs, just like not even paying attention. So went out round one, so it's just like people punching people.
Yeah.
It's like hockey.
Yeah, and I think I've ruffled Zelo's jimmies. With round one of that gauntlet.
He ruffled the world's jimmies.
And I think Tao's just about to get ringed out.
No, I have faith and confidence. Oh, okay, never mind. Okay, moving on to the next round.
Okay, moving on to the next fight. Oh, that was very anticlimactic. What?
Just whatever.
What?
All right, let's start the match and on to the next match.
Well, yeah, that's basically what happened.
I missed the replay. God damn it!
Basically, it started. Garlic Jr. turned Tao around and then kicked the crap out of Tao.
So not rushed him into the wall. Frieza versus King Piccolo. Gotcha.
Yeah. And here's Zarmon.
I'm not doing it. I'm pulling this shit again. Damn it, I'm pulling this shit again.
The laugh returns. So does our Lord and Savior PyCon. And a burning shoot. What? Oh! What? The pile driver doesn't drive them into the ground?
No, it's fine. Yeah, it's whatever. Zarmon's just, like, not pulling his weight.
Yeah. Right? Now, I think PyCon's going for his bullshit again. Where he's gonna throw his opponent into the ground before he gets it. And Zarmon just beat PyCon!
Damn it. Man, I love these quick matches. I just have to laugh for a little bit and not say a word. It's over.
And now I think it's Supreme Kai versus Future Gohan.
Such a labyrinth, and it's over. Yeah.
Where's Supreme Guy? There he is. I'm really sad that round two wasn't hit with the in the minors here for the gauntlet. I'm really proud of that team.
Well, Kane, you should be more proud of the first one, obviously.
I mean, the first one was public knowledge what was going to be going on with it.
Yeah.
I didn't tell people what I was doing to buff them, but it looks like I was a bit wrong. Anyways, is this a sparring match? No, it's Future Gohan. I was thinking of Ultimate Gohan.
Yeah, we don't have the money for Ultimate Gohan.
Yeah, man, the freaking rates that he demands.
Just give him like a chocolate bar. Do I look like I have the money for a chocolate bar?
Yeah, right? I mean, it's not like Saiyan Man where we just give him money and he comes.
Yeah, Ultimate Gohan, like, he's asking for some pricey shit.
Yeah, you know, like a sword, an old man dancing around him for two episodes. Like, really, we can't rent the old man out. Grandpa Gohan has a lot of shit to do.
Yeah, now that he's, like, not even competing right now.
Yeah, man, he sleeps a lot in the off season.
So he prepares for the next season. He just sleeps for a year.
Wow. And Gohan is just going at Supreme Kai. Who's going to Kabuto?
Future Gohan is listening to the chat and just being like, well, it's not Cell Stage, but I can just murder him. Whatever.
Oh, man. Gohan about to... They've been just going at it.
He's got a murder.
Hey, Gohan, you missed.
Solves my problem.
Yeah.
Gohan, we see Gohan, I wouldn't stand there. Okay, thank you.
That's super explosive wave. Bye, Kai. And that's the first KO we've had. Oh, man. It's a shame Grandpa Gohan's not in this tournament. Anyway, that's it for the first episode.
I'm gonna go check my eggs.
Alright, and I will be right back with the second one with you guys. Toodaloo.